A big shout out to Squarespace for sponsoring today's video. Hey all, before we start today's video, a quick reminder to participate in our monthly giveaways. This month's giveaway is sponsored by The Twisted Joy. Do check out their Instagram handle and also check the description for links and rules of how to participate in this giveaway. In my posts and videos, I've often spoken about how many plants appreciate a loose, nutrient-rich, well-draining, yet moisture-retaining mix that doesn't stay soggy, but is perfectly moist and also allows the roots of the plant to grow and breathe freely. This kind of soil helps a large group of plants to thrive. I know most plants grow pretty well in clay soil as well. I myself have not repotted many that are actually doing well in clay soil, like my stromanthi. But the slightly delicate ones that happen to be more expensive are the ones that will surely suffer in a dense and compacting soil mix. So you don't need to repot every plant into a soil mix made of these mediums that I will be showing you. But you need to make a calculated decision as to which plant you need to put in this mix, because most of these mediums are on the costly side. So I reserve the expensive mediums like pine bark, pumice, peat moss for plants like my anthuriums, monsteras, some philodendrons, and my hedera helix. I also reserve this mix for plants that can't deal with compacting clay soil around their roots. Even epiphytes or hemiepiphytes prefer a loose soil mix. This mix that I will be making at the end of the video is a soilless mix. I'm not adding any form of garden soil or clay soil into this mix. It's just a few mediums that I'm putting together, which is absolutely enough for the kind of plants that I spoke about. Now, I have personally tried out these and will be giving you my opinions on each one of them. I also will leave the links in the description of the ones that I have bought so that you can try it out as well if you want to. Do stay and watch until the end, where I will share with you my soilless recipe for most of my plants. Let's get started. Pumice. Pumice is mined volcanic rock that is extremely porous, lightweight, and has low density. It improves soil drainage and is an effective medium when it comes to your soil mixes. It comes in different sizes, so you could pick yours according to the needs of your plant. Some plants need a finer grain and some plants need a larger grain, so you can decide. It is a medium that is inert and allows the roots to breathe freely. So it works really well for epiphytes and for plants that don't want any compacting around their roots. And because it's inert, you can also use it for plants that don't want a very nutrient-rich soil medium. Perlite is quite similar to pumice in properties. The difference is perlite is mined and heated and it expands like popcorn and it becomes extremely lightweight and it is also very porous. It holds in water but also improves the aeration and drainage in the soil. So if you want to understand perlite better, you can also watch a video that I did some time back. I will leave the link in the description down below. Also, a tip: whenever you buy perlite, ensure that it is not handled too much because it breaks down to a fine powder very easily and it becomes pretty much useless in improving the drainage of your soil. So always buy perlite that is not handled too much and that is not broken down into a fine powder. You're simply wasting your money. Coco chips are simply derived from coconut husk. They are big size as compared to Coco Peat and they also help the roots to grow very freely. Again, these are used for growing epiphytes like orchids, hoyas. They improve and provide aeration to the roots and also when mixed in with other mediums makes for a great loose soil mix. So this is something I use frequently because it's not expensive like the other mediums that I will be showing you. It's quite cheap and it is effective as well. So this is another very good medium that you can use. Coco peat also is derived from coconut husk, but when you compare it with coco chips, it is much finer. It's broken down and it has water retaining properties, which is really good if you want to use a moisture retaining mix, if you want to make a mix that retains a lot of water. But the strange thing about coco peat is, though it is moisture retaining when soaked, but when it is completely dry, it becomes hydrophobic almost. That means it repels water and you have to be alert to see that when it has become completely dry, that you water the medium in a way that it is completely soaked again. Or parts of the peat won't get wet and it will dry up the roots and your plant may suffer. So the best thing to do in such a situation is fill a bowl with water and dip your plant into that. Keep your plant soaked in that bowl of water and let it soak the water from the bottom. That way it will slowly soak all the water and the medium will get soaked again. So this is something you need to remember when you're using only coco peat as a soil medium. The next one is pine bark, and it is derived from the outer bark of pine trees. They are shredded and chopped chunks. Again, this is used for epiphytes and hemiepiphytes, mostly for orchids and hoyas. This medium is on the costly side again. So what you can do is easily substitute it with coco chips, which are more affordable, and they pretty much do the same thing for your soil mix. But if you want to use it for some plants that are delicate or very expensive, then you can go ahead and buy this one. Now, one thing you need to remember with pine bark is don't buy the very fine bits, because again, they will decompose fast and they will not provide what you want for your soil for a longer time. Go for the bigger chunks and go for the bigger sized pine bark. Another interesting medium, and which has become my favorite, and I use it in all my soil mixes, is charcoal. But one thing you need to keep in mind is when you buy charcoal to mix into your garden soil, just ensure that it is not treated with any fire accelerants or any chemicals, and it is a horticulture grade charcoal. Charcoal absorbs water well, it provides drainage and decomposes really slowly. So it makes the mix loose and allows the roots to breathe as well. I mix it up in my soil mixes as well as in my soilless mixes, and I use it often, everywhere actually. So I'm falling in love with this medium and I'm using it more often. Now the one that I have bought here is pretty big chunks. So orchids and hoyas might enjoy such huge big chunks. But for other plants, I would break it down with a hammer and bring it down to a smaller size like this and use it that way. Red brick chunks can be easily found in construction shops, and you can break it down with a hammer to the size that you want and then mix it up with your soil. One thing that you need to keep in mind when you are sourcing these is ensuring that where you got it from was not exposed to, it was not exposed to any chemicals, especially if you're planning to use it for your vegetable garden and things like that. Just wash down the brick completely properly before you break it down and mix it in. Red brick chunks have been used by gardeners since years, and it is something that is very easy to use and it's affordable, very cheap. So it's a good medium to mix in if you want your soil to be a little more well-draining. Now the thing is that this is just simply clay that is baked. So it will eventually break down, but when it breaks down, it won't become clay again. It will be a slightly sandy kind of medium. So I don't personally use this in large quantities. I use a little bit in my mix, just very little. So that's up to you. You can use it how you want to based on your experience with it. I have very recently started using red brick in my gardening. So probably in the future, I will put more information about it, about how it has to be used and the benefits of it and things like that. Cinder is getting really popular these days and is used for plants like cacti, succulents, rose plants and adenium because it's super well-draining. And if you can see the texture, it just lets the water drain out easily. And it's perfect for plants that don't like too much water around their roots. When you buy cinder, just ensure that you get a good quality one. There are some sellers who sell low-quality cinder. I have recently started experimenting with this medium, and I will in the future put more videos on this one. And this one here is washed cinder that I have, which is a little more costly than the unwashed one. The unwashed one will have a lot more dust than the washed one. Okay. I usually, how I use this is I don't use this alone as a mix solo for any plant. I have not yet experimented with that, but what I do is I mix a little bit of it into my soil mix just to increase the draining capacity of my soil. I don't know how effective it is, me adding cinder into my soil mix, but I'm definitely experimenting with this one. And it is up to you because it's a little costly. And if you want to eliminate it from your soil mix, it's absolutely okay. Now, this here is peat moss, which is a non-renewable resource. And that is why I wouldn't recommend using it so freely. Please be careful. Don't keep buying peat moss so much. It is dark brown in color and it is fine and fiber-like. It is formed in bogs where sphagnum moss and other organic material decomposes over thousands of years and the process is extremely slow. Many countries have very strict rules in place that are implemented so that it doesn't affect the environment when peat moss is mined over there. However, when we talk about the benefits of this medium, it is perfect to absorb and hold moisture. I use peat moss rarely. I only use it for plants that really like it, like my Hedera helix. It is acidic and suits plants that like such soil, like strawberry plants. Peat can also be used to break down clay soil, like Coco Peat or Vermicompost also breaks down clay soil. But I personally would always substitute it with Coco Peat or compost whenever I can. Because not only is it expensive, I would avoid it because the medium has a long-standing effect on the environment. So, I wouldn't tell you all to buy this medium freely, but I would always say that you substitute it with Coco Peat and Vermicompost, which is absolutely decent enough. You can also tweak the pH levels in many other ways. You don't need to add in peat moss only. Can always substitute this one. Now we come to the last medium, but not the least. It's one of the most important mediums. I use it a lot. This is vermicompost. You can use homemade compost or vermicompost. It is another great medium to add into clay soil to break it up, and it is nutrient rich as well. So I always use this in most mixes I make, and I also use it to fertilize my plants occasionally. Vermicompost is simply the breakdown of organic waste by earthworms or other worms. That is why it is also called worm castings or worm manure. This I use as the base of all my soilless mixes too. So whenever I want to break down clay soil and whenever I want to make a soilless mix and I need a base for it, I use vermicompost as the base and then I add mediums to make it better. So this is my go-to for all my soil mixes. I've just given you a brief idea of all these mediums. If you want to know more about each one of these mediums and in more detail, then please let me know in the comments down below. I will try to continue this series. I will now share my basic, well-draining, soilless mix with you. I am sharing only what has worked for me. So please don't follow me blindly, but understand these mediums completely before you use them. And it will work for you. I noticed an immediate change in my plants. For example, my anthurium radicans had completely died down. Even the last leaf had gone and it was an expensive plant and I didn't want to lose it. So I put it in this mix and it threw out a new shoot immediately and I have a leaf on it and the plant is doing very well. So in my experience, I would say this has worked for some of my aroids really well. And I would recommend this mix to you guys. But please, again, don't follow me blindly. Always experiment, try out, because everyone's experiences are their own and are different. So what I do for my basic aroid mix is, I take 4 parts vermicompost, 2 part Coco Peat, 1 part pumice, 1 part perlite, 1 part cinder, 1 part pine bark, 2 parts horticultural charcoal, and sometimes I add a little crushed red brick. You can tweak the measurements as you understand each medium and how they act. You can increase quantities, you can decrease quantities, and you can make a mix that suits your plants. Now in reality, when I make my mix, I don't measure out the parts. I'm doing this only for your benefit. I simply pour in the medium from the packets and I mix them all together. So as you garden more and more, you will have the confidence to do that. And you will be able to tweak the mediums and make your own perfect soil mix. So you have been seeing the buzz on my store and all the new products that have been recently launched. If you haven't, go check it out now. I want to talk to you about Squarespace, which is a powerful and beautiful online platform where you can create your own website. They have some really unique and beautiful templates to choose from, which lets you easily connect with your audience and at the same time generate revenue through gated members-only content that you provide on your website. You can build a community, manage members, send email communications, and leverage audience insights all within one easy-to-use platform. So if you are planning to launch your own small business, go to squarespace.com for a free trial to get a feel of the platform. And when you are ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/geeksofgreen to save 10% on your first purchase of a website or a domain. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, then please do give us a thumbs up and also subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so yet. Hit the bell icon to join the notification squad and participate in our giveaways. I hope to see you soon in another video. Till then, stay green.